Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off this video, we are taking a look at the r/SpaceX launch manifest. As you can see, we can hopefully expect the launch of Starlink 4-5 tomorrow, January 6th at 9:49pm UTC or 4:49pm Eastern Time. To start the Boca Chica updates, work has been continuing on the orbital launch mount. Scaffolding was seen being removed from the Mechazilla launch tower. The Chopstick catching arms were seen being moved up and down as they are tested. The catching arms were also seen opening up for the first time. Earthwork has been going on with the berm at the launch site. Here's a view of the construction progress on the wide bay. The stairs behind the high bay continue to be constructed. Elon Musk posted a tweet back in 2019 saying Raptor reached 268.9 bar today, exceeding prior record held by the awesome Russian RD-180. Then he also posted a tweet a few days ago saying Raptor 2 now operates routinely at 300 bar main chamber pressure. Starship 20 continues to sit on suborbital pad B awaiting more testing, and Booster 4 is sitting on the landing pad. Crews were seen removing heat shield tiles from Ship 20's lift points. Taking a look at the road and beach closures again, the dates for this week remain as they were in the last video. We can hopefully expect some testing either today, January 5th, or tomorrow based on the current closures. Here's a view of the Starship 21 body section sitting in the mid bay. The nose is still sitting outside the high bay in the yard. The Ship 24 common dome was recently sleeved with its barrel section. Michael Baylor posted a tweet about this Starship 24 common dome section. He said Ship 24's common dome has been sleeved and there is no methane header tank included. Will it be moved to the nose cone, Elon Musk? Musk responded and said yes. SpaceX's crane was moved back over and hooked up once again to the Super Heavy Booster 4 prototype. Here's a view of Booster 7 currently being constructed inside the high bay. As always, thank you to Mary or Boca Chica Gal for being out there all the time filming the Starbase content. As well, thank you to Nick Antsuini for being out there filming some of the Starbase content too. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.